Welcome back to Acreate. This is the following up tutorial for the tank arena battle game that I started last week. I will continue exactly at the same spot, so it's really advisable to just watch the first video first. And this week we are going to fix the health bar collision, make pickups, make them work, and make different viewports and add a mini map. So let's get started. Last week we did a lot in half an hour, but don't forget to double check your health bar if you added minus damage, because I didn't mention it in the video, but it's very important, otherwise your health bar will not deplete. Another way to improve the collisions is by clicking on solid object on the object wall 1 and object wall 2, and also change the collisions in the sprite manager. For the walls, this is fairly easy because you can just click on collision mask and game maker and automatically fills up the collision on the whole image on the 56 by 56, all our pixels, and we'll get a collision mask. For the tank, I don't really like the preset settings because I think it's too big, so I want to have a different type. You can just change the tolerance below, but I like to use the ellipse because it just takes like from the beginning to the end, like a nice circle around it, which makes the collision more accurate. Now we want to add some more tactics in the game. So we were going to create a new sprite, sprite pickup, and we are going to give it 3 different images. This week we are going to use other images, but still from Kenny. The link will be down below. Just import them one by one. Use the full image and start with the bullets, the shield, and then the repair icon. Change the actual size to canvas size, skill image to 64x64. Apply and add an easy collision mask. Create a new object. Create object. Name it as object pickup. Assign the pickup sprite. Create event and assign a new variable. We call this variable kinds. So it will be a new variable and we will assign choose 0, 1, 2. Note that I start with 0 in Game Maker, and in most other languages, a computer started with counting on 0. Add a jump to point, and we are going to use a random function. So random range. It already is here, a random range. And it tells us a random range between 0 and... Well, later I'm going to make the map bigger, so I already used that value. And I will do the same with the I value, random range, 1280. And we will also add a set alarm. So set alarm, 0. And we use the random function also here. But first we want to add 100 plus random 500. Which means that it will every 3 to 20 seconds will jump to another position. Well, that's what we are going to create. So we copy this create event and we will paste it, and we'll say this is the alarm. And now we double check the kind of same random range and we restart the alarm. At last we will add a draw event, draw. Use sprites and draw itself. We will have the relative position and the frame will be kind. Now we go back to the parent tank and make a collision event with the pickup object. So now you notice that whenever you already added an event, Game Maker will always remember that the event existed and will give you back all the functions that you used in it before. Well, I'm just going to delete it because I wanted to make it from scratch again. Well, I think it is a really nice feature from Game Maker, because often when you're making a game, you're like trying and tweaking, and then you suddenly are like, oh, I maybe should have used that again, and then it's still somewhere in the system. Okay, so now we want to assign the variable damage, so every time when we pick it up, it will be like the max 0 and then the damage minus 50, so it's not going over our value of 100. And we also want to add a value that we didn't assign yet, so I'm going to do that in the next step. So minus 1, the weapon is minus 1, and in the create event we want to assign a new variable called weapon. So when it's not a crate of repair, it will show an item. To visualize what I just created, I will already make the sprite for the weapons. So create sprite. I'm just going to rename it to sprite weapon. And I will open the edit image editor and import image. I will choose the tank bullet 3 as the first image and second image, import image. Shields, tank explosion. I mean, I think it's a nice shield. And we will take one of the gray ones and move to the right. And we delete the first one. So this means that this is the first sprite, this is the second, and the last one is empty. And we want to go back to the parent tank and assign new variable in the create event, the variable shield. Now we double check on the sprite pick up. The second image is the shield, which means that we will create a variable check again on the pickup if it is other kind one. Drag the new variable out of the other kind two, so out here, so it is a new if statement. So other kind one, value one. Drag in the variable set shield to 10 and add the variable weapon and set it to other kind, so it will pick the shield image, so other kind. We want to set alarm to let the shield disappear over time. Now we are going to make the alarm. I realized the value of the shield didn't really matter because we use an alarm, but 10 is a nice number, so don't attack the 10. Alarm 0 and variable shield back to -1. And we will use the variable weapon to -0 so it's not showing any image again. For the special rocket, we want to add a new variable called ammo. And we want to go back to the object pickup and check again the if variable of other kind. Variable other kind equals 0. So we have 0, 1, and 2. Like what we did with the others, we want to set the weapon to other kind. And we want to add the ammo by 1 every time when we pick it up. We set it on relative. After the player hits the pickup, we want to like move the player. Don't put it in any if variable, just after all if variable. In the object big rocket, we have a create event and we will set point direction object tank 2.x and object tank 2.i. So the I value of the tank 2 on the x and the I value and the direction on 8. And for the collision object tank 2, we are going to check first if it has a variable shield. So is it less or equal? Assign the variable damage. So we will hit it. And we will create the instant small explosion. And we also will add the collision with the bullets in the same way. So bullet controller, create instant small explosion, relative position, and destroy instant. Duplicates the rockets, control D, and call it rockets 2. And before you're going to change this one, you need to open it so it will load all the functions and then change the events to collision object tank 1. The next step is to add the new button press to the tanks. So for object tank 1, I'm going to use the key down Z key to shoot the rocket. First, we check if the player has a rapid fire, so can shoot. Is 0, then in case we don't do anything. We drag another if variable in case we can shoot. And also check if the weapon is 0. So weapon is equal to 0. And we will also check if instance exists. If there is an object 2. In that case, we want to create object number 1, the rocket 1. Because player 1 is shooting. Set the x and I value on relative. And we want to decline the ammo by 1. So ammo value -1 and set it to relative. Now we want to check if the ammo is less than 1. So if ammo is less than 1, In that case, we don't have the rocket anymore, so we want to set the weapon back to minus one. So weapon minus one. And we also want to add the can shoot variable. So set it to 10 so that it cannot fire immediately again. We copy all of these functions, Control A, Control C, and go back to tank two. And now we want to add the event key down enter. And we want to paste it. And we want to change object to object tank one to check if object tank one is existing. And to change it to create the object two. Go back to the object parent tank. Check in the object pack up if the jump to point is set to other. And now we are going to draw the right. So I could have created the objects just by creating a new object and stuff, but I want to use the draw event. And why I want to do this? This is because later on I'm going to change the room settings. I'm going to change it to different values. So I will already fix an issue that we will acquire if we are going to do that. So I'm going to say this event draw UI, we are going to change this. We are going to change this event and tell it to just draw normally. And I'm going to force unchild this object and just assign them back. Now I want to check if it's working. So I'm just going back to object tank one, and now I'm seeing the draw health bar is already assigned there. And I want to click on inherit events. So we will have another event. So we have the show parent event and a normal draw event. So we're going to set a draw sprite event here. So we are going to draw the tank instead of creating it by itself. And we will put it on relative position. And we set the frame to minus one. And we add a call parent event. So call event parents. We do the same with object tank two. So going to the draw event, a right mouse button, inherit event, draw sprites, draw the red tank, set it to relative, and set it to frame to minus one. And call parent event. And this way we already fix the viewport issue. So we go back to the parent tank and going to draw the sprites of the weapons. So now we are going to use the value weapon that we use a lot. So the if variable is weapon is one. In case there is a shield, we're going to draw the shield. We drag in the shield. We choose the sprites from the weapon. And we are going to say minus 64 because the shield is a bit bigger. Again, minus 64 and put it on relative and call the frame of the weapon that is in place. For the next one, we first want to create a new font. So create font, smaller font for the ammo. We build a font ammo and we regenerate it. Okay, now we go back to the parent tank. And if the weapon is zero, so outside of the weapon if variable checking one. So if weapon is zero, in that case, we draw the sprites of the weapon again. So sprites, weapon, relative position, frame, weapon. I'm going to change it to x25 and i25. We call the font, so font, that font, and we choose ammo. And we draw the value of the ammo, so draw value caption nothing, because we don't want any extra stuff. Ammo. And I want to have it on the value of 24 in relative position of the tank. To test it, we just open the room one and drag in the object pickup. So drag in some pickups and press F5. Notice that you get a very strange cannot assign ammo, and that is because we already have ammo in the game. So change all the ammos to MOS. So in the draw event and in the pickup event, we change it with the ammo to S. In object tank one also the MOS, and this should work. Now you will have something like this, like with the ammo, and it shoot the other player. Just don't really like that the sprite image of the Rocket is so big, and that comes because we use the sprite weapon also for the shield. So we are going to not use normal drawing of the sprite, but a transform sprite. So we do the same, and then we assign a different skill. So set the sprite weapon. Frame to weapon. X value minus 25. Y value 25. Position in relative, and the scale on 0.5. And you can tweak this by yourself. So you tweak the numbers that you like, you go to create and set the weapon 0 to minus 1, so we don't see any rocket in the beginning. If you don't have a rocket, you don't see a rocket. We're going to make the game more interesting now, so we click on the room and we're going to change the view settings. First thing I'm going to do is to make the room bigger. So also on the eye value. And now I go down to viewports and cameras. I scroll down, I enable viewports, and I'm going to set the first viewport of the first tank. Set this view on visible, use the settings of the width 400, width 480, and the other viewport properties width 400 and 480, and check in to find and follow the object tank 1. And to have horizontal border of 200 and the vertical border of 240 and minus 1 to both. So if you go up now, you see in the corner there is a very nice view for the first player. In the same way, we make the viewport for player 2, make it visible, have the setting of 400 and 480. Change the X position to 420 so it goes to the other side of the room. And the width to 400 and 480, and follow object tank 2. Drag the tank in the other corner and check the view. As you can see, the score is only on the viewport of player 1 and not on the player 2 viewport. So we're going to change that, but we would have the same issue with the health bar and all the other things if we didn't use the draw event as before, because this is a UI problem. To fix this issue, we click on the controller and instead we use like the normal X value and I value, we're going to use viewport. So the viewport 0 means the first player and viewport 1 means the other player. So we just copy this one small and change the viewport to 1. And we scroll down to draw value as well and then change the other sides. Plus 100. And viewport 0. Duplicate this and change the viewport to 1. And now it should fix the UI issue. At last, I want to add a viewport for a minimap, so I change the settings to the width so it's going to see the whole room, but it's not going to show it on the whole room. It's just going to say on the X position 350, I position 335, and the width and the height, so it will be a small little square with a minimap. The last step is just fix your room, change the map, add some other things, make a nice level, and then you're finished to go. Well done, you made it to the end. Feel free to change the game to your own needs and desires. Just let me know if you need more help or some advice. And don't forget to subscribe and have a nice weekend.